We are surprised to note that the Kenya National Examination Council have sent out a circular to all our schools, which are examination centers for Kenya Certificate of Primary Education and Kenya Certificate of Secondary Education, advising that all examination centers that have less than 40 students or 40 pupils will be consolidated, and the learners will be expected to sit exams in other centers that have got those numbers. Now, I think, in my opinion, as an educationist also, I think it is a very misplaced arrangement. First and foremost, now we are dealing with COVID-19, and as such, that means we have to consider the issue of social distance. It doesn't make sense for the examination council to be asking that we have more children in our centers than the numbers that are there. In fact, if anything, we should be reducing. Quality of education is even better the smaller the class size. So when you want to consolidate and put all the children in one school, that will not help us. Secondly, of course, the children or the learners that will move from their school to the other will be operating from a new environment, and that is going to affect their concentration in the exams. Those that will be in their own centers will also be distracted by the ones coming from outside. And we are humans, and human beings are social animals. So the time taken to do private studies and final studies before exams will be taken in introductions and in people getting to know each other. So I believe that is a very, very wrong move for the examination center to take. And I want to advise them to withdraw. Secondly, thirdly, there's been no consultation. Our principals do not know. Our head teachers do not know. Our teachers do not know. Private schools do not know. Nobody seems to have been consulted. I'm wondering, who is it that this examination council talks to? The Constitution of Kenya is very clear that before you do certain major legal moves, you must consult the public. It is called public participation. It is in Article 10 of the Constitution of the Republic of Kenya. Finally, on the same matter, any directive that has the full effect of law must be taken to Parliament through the Delegated Legislation Committee. It is under the Statutory Instruments Act. So whatever they are doing is null and void. So I want to advise that the Ministry of Education, C.S. Magoa, please withdraw that circular. Advise your people to follow the law and tell them that it doesn't make sense, whatever it is that they are planning. We want our children to learn in the centers where they have been educated all their lives and to do their exams there. You will not be able to take responsibility for any action or any problem that might occur. We have had principals complain that they have disciplined their children. Then you want to bring other children from other schools. We do not know the level of discipline in each school. So we cannot consolidate children from one school to the other. Even the ministry has said that they do not want that thing of movement. So suddenly I wonder when they come up with such a circular. So that, I think, is something that we are going to fight even as a parliament.